Hi everyone, I'm a tutor. To create a bootable USB flash drive, Microsoft recommends the media creation tool. There are other programs for burning a slot to a USB flash drive. Rufus is quite popular. In this video, I will show you how Rufus works. Let's take a look at some features that not everyone know about. To create a bootable flash drive, we need an ordinary flash drive of 8 GB or more. We also need a program. As I said, today we use Rufus. I download the program from the official site. I'll enter the address in the address bar. If needed, you can use link number 1 in the description of this video. Here we go down to the word download. The latest version of Rufus is 3.18. When you download, the version may be never. This is not so important. I click here. Click to gray background. The program has been downloaded. I open the downloads folder. I start the program. Confirm. If in the future you plan to download ISO images using Rufus, allow it to be updated. Let's talk about it in another video. Click yes. I need an ISO image of Windows to burn to a flash drive. I have shown in detail how to download Windows 10 ISO in this video. If you don't have an image, perhaps the video will be useful for you. First of all, let's check the disk layout on this computer. To do this, I right-click on the Start button. I choose Disk Management. This is the hard drive of this computer. I do a right-click here. In the context menu, select Properties. In the window that opens, click on the Volumes tab. The partition style Master Boot Record, MBR. I just remember this disk has a MBR layout. If you saw this here, the new disk has a GPT partition. Remember this. The device field is currently empty. It's time to connect the flash drive. Attention! If you have unnecessary files on the flash drive, save them somewhere. During the recording process, all information from the flash drive will be deleted. I connected a USB drive. The device appeared in the first field. If do you have another flash drive connected at this moment or external drive, I recommend to disable them, in order not to accidentally format. Now I need to tell Rufus where the ISO image is. To do this, I press a select button. The ISO file is on my desktop. Select the ISO file. Press open. ISO appeared in the boot selection field. Now I need to check the partition scheme settings. The rule is simple. If your disk is partitioned in MBR, choose MBR. If your partition is GPT, select GPT here. I choose MBR. It is better not to touch the target system field. The setting will be selected automatically, depending on what is selected here. I don't touch anything else, press start. Rufus warns that he will delete anything from the flash drive. I already said this. Press OK. Now a few words about booting from the USB flash drive. It is not difficult for a user who often does this. He can burn and flash drive with any program. Boot from a USB flash drive and install the system. but most users rarely do this, or maybe the user for first time decided to install Windows himself. One mistake during the installation process can turn a user off. Stop waiting to do it again. Rufus can help such users make booting from the flash drive easier. Let's look at an example. I have created an installation flash drive to install Windows. I need to boot the computer from the USB flash drive. There are several ways to boot from USB flash drive. I can enter the BIOS or UEFI of the computer and put the flash drive in place of the first boot device. But it's faster and easier to use the boot menu. On this computer, to call the boot menu, I need to press the F9 key at the time of booting or rebooting the computer. I restart my computer. I start pressing F9. Boot menu appeared. This is a list of boot devices for this computer. To boot from flash drive, I need to find it in the list and select it. My flash drive is easy to find. It was made by famous manufacturer SanDisk. Here is my flash drive. I just need to select the flash drive and press enter and install Windows as usual. As you can see, there is only one line with the name of the flash drive. The user cannot make a mistake when choosing. If I burn the flash drive using Microsoft Media Creation Tool, there will be two entries with the name of the flash drive. One of these items labeled UEFI. I have to select an item that matches my disk layout. In my case, this is an item without UEFI. If I select the wrong item, the following error will occur during installation. Using Rufus, I am guaranteed against such an errors. By default, Rufus writes just such flash drives separately for MBR and GPT partitioning. If desired, you can configure Rufus so that he writes a universal flash drive, which is suitable for both markups. The same on that Media Creation Tool writes. I run Rufus as usual. I choose the ISO image. Then I press Alt plus E at the same time. In the status bar, we see Dual UEFI BIOS mode enabled. Now you can burn a universal flash drive. In the partition scheme field, select MBR. Then we do it as usual. If you decide to disable dual mode, press the same combination again. We see Dual UEFI BIOS mode disabled. Now Rufus is working in his normal mode. Thanks for watching my videos. Please like this video if it was helpful. Subscribe and you don't miss the next video. Perhaps the video will be useful to your friends. Please share with them. I wish all viewers health. My name is Evgeny Yurtaev. See you soon.